Mother Marianne Cope is one of seven people being canonized at the Vatican this weekend. Today, the U.S. State Department extended its appreciation for her work and that of the first Native American saint. Gina Mangieri reports.
Civic and religious recognition came together as the U.S. Ambassador to the Holy See hosted a reception at the Vatican Museum Garden in honor of Mother Marianne Cope and a Mohawk-Algonquin Christian named Kateri Tekakwitha.
I think it's a wonderful opportunity to celebrate the contribution of American women, in this case, two wonderful women who gave so much of themselves to serve the poor, to serve the most in need.
This is kind of a rare thing that we would have two saints canonized at the same ceremony, and so it's something that even the civic community wants to celebrate.
The U.S. State Department has had a diplomatic tie here since 1984 with the Holy See, the Vatican City State's sovereign governmental entity.
And the Vatican intervenes quite a bit in some of these issues, and certainly does a lot of charitable outreach and missionary work, and knows the countries very well and has connections everywhere. So it's very important for the U.S. State Department to work with the Vatican.
Religious leaders in attendance included Cardinal Bernard Law, who is among Vatican elders since his departure as Boston's Archbishop. The diplomatic outreach extended to Honolulu's bishop and other island priests, plus representatives from Native American and other mainland parishes who traveled to honor Blessed Kateri.
She really stood by her faith. She was really martyred because the Mohawks would persecute her. They didn't want her to be Catholic. It helped bring Native Americans from different tribes together, and what their common bond was being Christian.
The U.S. ambassador received a kamaka ukulele from Honolulu's bishop, and the hundreds of guests learned about Mother Marianne and Hawaii through chants, hula, and plenty of aloha spirit. So just outside the walls of a place, the Vatican Museum, that holds culture and art from around the world, Hawaii was able to leave its own mark of culture and celebration. Reporting from Rome, Gina Mangieri, KHON2 News, Hawaii's news leader.